I'm actually going to be having a new wedding ceremony for my friends and family with my husband, and we're going to have it at a castle. So you know what that means? I went shopping. And oh, I hope I didn't break anything. But in there, I'm going to be creating my brand new wedding dress. And this means my forever wedding dress that I want my children to look back on my photos and be like, wow, that's a mommy in her wedding dress versus my previous wedding dress as before. Yeah, so it's not the fact that I didn't like my previous wedding dress. No, it's like that was a rush job. And I really want a dress that is what I want in my fairy tale Cinderella wedding dress. That's what I've always wanted, and you know what? I'm going to make it. So my husband went out and got me the fabrics for it that I asked because he went to America. I'm still in Denmark. And so he got me the fabrics. So this is going to be a long, arduous process of me showing you how I'm going to be making my wedding dress step by step. That way, if you are interested, you can do it yourself. So stay tuned for the entire series, and thanks so much for watching. If you're new to my channel, make sure to subscribe. Let's go ahead and get started. So it's time to see what's inside this bag. This bag is from Joann's. I'm not sponsored. First things first, I'm going to be using my base fabric as this nice mesh. It's kind of like a tulle, unfortunately. So it's a mesh tulle, and actually it feels amazing on my hands. Just in case we got a lot, just if I ripped something and something bad. So this will be going a long way and giving me some oomph in the skirt. By the way, this does not apply to that. So this is the first fabric that we have here. The second fabric is going to be my actual very nice embellishing fabric. This one is actual bridal material that we got from Joann's, and it looks so beautiful. So I'm very happy that my husband got me this much material, and I have a lot of room to play with. So I'll be using the entire bottom portion of this stuff. Here, you can see the crystals, the pearls, the sequins. This is very beautiful stuff. I'm going to be using this into the bottom hem, of course, because I'm bougie like that. And then of course we got this part here. It's just very well done. Like, props to Joann's. This was probably the most expensive fabric, being I think about $50 per yard, I think. So you could already see it starting to come along. And then of course, no dress is complete with its alternate fabric. So this is actually going to be the skirt fabric and the base fabric for the inside of the dress, because I just need it to have sheer volume. It's a little thin, unfortunately, so I'm going to have to put a little bit of tulle on the inside. And I hope to goodness that it's as big as I need it to be. So this one I have 5 yards of, because I want my dress to be huge. For extra embellishments, we got silver string so I can hand embroider, just in case. We have like 4 of them. You never know how much thread you're gonna run out. Also got some extra crystals to bling in certain areas. And then a bag of pearls. All in all, I'm not supposed to know how much this costed. And here's another bag of crystals. Grand total came out to about 200. He took all of this. This was 3 yards actually, not 1.5. So this is 3 yards and then a little bit extra. So this is what we're working with today. We're going to be working with all of these materials to work on my wedding dress. My first wedding dress was a sweetheart neckline, and I really didn't want it to be the same. So instead I wanted a V neckline down to my cleavage. I wanted it to be very elegant and pretty, and also I wanted sleeves. So I put a lot of paper onto my dress form and drafted out the pattern that I wanted, and then I cut off the pattern. I have a dart in the front so it's nice and cinched, but I'm going to go ahead and cut it out into a few different pieces. This is what my pieces look like laid out. I have a side panel piece, I have the front piece, and then I have a back piece. So, of course, what I'm going to do is cut it all out. Make sure that I have 2 pieces of each. Now, following my pattern pieces, I'm going to sew it all together, making sure that it's aligned properly. I thought the mesh was actually going to be too light, so I decided to use an A-line pattern such as this. I'm going to be using the white material underneath it and then lay the lace on top. So again, I'm going to be pinning down the material and then cutting it out on my white material. Here, I'm actually going to deviate a little bit from the pattern and make the skirt bigger. I made sure to spread out the rest of the skirt pieces, but just in case it's not the same length, it's all right. I could always hem it to the right length it needs to be. Now let's take it to the sewing machine and sew it all together. So I wanted to be completely transparent. I started working on the sleeves and this is what it looks like. The sleeves are really long, but they're too forward because of the pattern I made. It was making the dress sit really weird, and then I realized the shape isn't everything that I want it to be. So I'm probably going to start the top over from scratch and then keep the bottom part. I like the shape that it has right now, but it doesn't fit. So now we're going to go back and I'm going to be using part of a pattern that's commercially made, such as this one. Oh wait, yeah, this one. I'm going to be using the C pattern as long and using the A sleeves. I don't want the sleeves to be exactly what this is, but that's what's going on right now. Documenting the process. Okay. Even though I don't need all the pattern pieces, I'm going to go ahead and cut and separate them out right now. And then the pieces that I don't need, I'll just fold and put them back away in the little pamphlet. Thing that I learned is after you cut out your pattern pieces and they're still kind of crinkly, you're supposed to actually iron them. So now we have more ironing. Always ironing. Ironing for life. Measuring myself. I figured out that I will be using a size 10 in this pattern. So now I'm going to be cutting it out on this tool. Can you see the tool? It's kind of like see-through. But the main reason we're doing tool is because I want to add the lace on top and give it the illusion that I'm not wearing a top. Okay, so we've had a long day of trying to recuperate from the loss that I just had with my wedding dress. This is where we're at now. I reshaped the cups here and then I actually sewed down the sides. They're no longer basting stitches and this is a brand new a brand new top. The sleeves actually fit this time and then the back is not sealed. The back isn't sealed because whenever I lift my arms a little bit, it makes the dress runch up. So I had to figure out if I want it to be a zipper or not, or what to do. I need to figure out if I want to install a boning channel or anything like that. But as you can see, this dress is very sheer. I don't like it being too sheer. Like, I don't know, but right now I want to go ahead and start like sewing it on and then detailing it and then figure out what I'm going to do about making it feel nice, because it looks nice right now. But it's just held up with pins, and then I want to go ahead and start using the lace. So, hooray! That's going to take forever, and I don't want my hands to hurt. My corset that I'm sewing in is actually blue, which is kind of like a fashion faux pas. You shouldn't put something darker underneath white, but I think it'll be fine. Anyways, I'm installing the boning channels right now using this light blue ribbon. This is actually one of my favorite corset patterns, and it's Simplicity S5006, and it's in the costume section. I'm going back to my original pattern that I started at the beginning and using the mesh fabric that I just bought, and I'm going to be cutting this out. My original pattern did not have a sleeve, so I went ahead and made my own pattern using my measurements. I wanted my sleeve to go all the way to my fingers, so I just left it as long as possible. Now I'm going to take everything that I just cut out to the sewing machine and sew it together. I love light purple, it's one of my favorite colors, and I decided to put it into my wedding dress as the zipper of the back of the mesh. Alright, so I wanted to show you the difference of having the stretchy mesh. Having stretchy mesh is so important for when you want to raise your hands up, especially if you want to toss your bouquet. Having stretchy mesh is also good to kind of like have an illumination of like imagining that this is your skin color and tone. This is kind of flesh tone, obviously it's mesh. I am going to be adding the corset part and dress part separately to this and not the same way that I had originally thought. So now I'm thinking of adding it lower, but I think that's too sexy for my wedding, so I'm going to add it here. This is obviously the lining, so I'm going to position this one first and it's going to be attached like this. This way, it just looks better. Once I have this positioned properly, I'm going to sew it down and then I'm going to add the dress on top of it. The reason why I'm doing it this way instead of sewing the mesh in between
is because I definitely want this to stay put. Like, I couldn't get this on and make it fit unless I had done the zipper. So the way I'm going to be doing this is adding the corset part, or adding this lining part first. So I'll be adding this first while here, and then I'm going to sew the dress on top. Once I have all of that together and this part together, I'm going to add the corset lacing at the side together there, and then close the seam last. The reason why I'm doing it that way is because this way I know that it fits the mesh to a T. And this way I can still kind of provide like support. So it'll look like this. And I'm kind of excited for it to look this tight. Very excited. I know this looks very Elsa-y or Sleeping Beauty Aurora-esque, but I needed something blue for my wedding, and I just thought this would be a nice little addition.